kids, how are you today? I hope you're doing fine and feeling excited for today's lesson. I'm Teacher Jenny, and I'll be discussing interactions among living things and non-living things in tropical rainforests, tropical coral reefs, and mangrove swamps. So, are you ready? Okay, so interaction among living things, either plants or animals, can be seen everywhere. Small, big, weak or strong organisms need each other for continuity of life.
Here are our goals for today's lesson. Identify the living and non-living things in tropical rainforest, coral reef, and mangrove swamp. Describe the appearance of tropical rainforest, coral reef, and mangrove swamp.
Explain the interactions among living and non-living things in a tropical rainforest, coral reef, and mangrove swamp in terms of harmful and beneficial interactions and effects of interaction.
So let's try this activity to check how much you know about the interactions among living things.
Identify what is being described or asked in each item. Write the letter of the correct answer in your notebook.
Your science teacher will collect your answers. Number 1. Which of the following is considered as a living thing? A. Flower. B. Stone. C. Sun. D. Water. Number 2. What interaction occurs when two organisms of different species benefit from each other? A. Commensalism. B. Mutualism. C. Parasitism. Or D. Predation. Number 3. Blank is a relationship between a host and a parasite. A. Commensalism. B. Mutualism. C. Parasitism. Or D. Predation. Number 4. Which of the following is considered as a non-living thing? A. Beetles. B. Birds. C. Grass. D. Wood. Number 5. What type of relationship where one of the organisms benefits and the other is not helped nor harmed? A. Commensalism. B. Mutualism. C. Parasitism. D. Predation.
How did you find the test? Don't worry if you get a low score. This just means that there are more things that you can learn from this video.
The following terms used in this video defined as follows. Living things are organisms that possess life processes. Non-living things are objects that do not exhibit life processes.
Tropical rainforest is composed of different varieties of plants, animals, and non-living things. Harmful is causing or likely to cause damage. Beneficial is producing good results or helpful effects. Mangrove swamp is confined to the tidal mud flats at the mouth of bodies of water where the water is brackish. Confined is restricted in area or volume. Estuary is the tidal mouth of large river where the tide meets the stream. Brackish is the mixture of river water and sea water in estuaries. Lagoon is a stretch of salty water separated from the sea by a low sandbank or coral reefs. Let's do this activity. Activity 1, entitled Find Me. Materials needed, activity notebook, ball pen, picture of tropical rainforest. Procedure. From the picture, identify the living and non-living things in the tropical rainforest ecosystem by listing them down in the table.
Here is an example of the table. In the first column, you will write the living things, and in the second column, you you will write the non-living things that you can identify in the picture.
Observe the picture. I'll be giving you 5 minutes to answer, or you can pause the video.
Answer the guide question. What makes a rainforest? Please write your answers in your activity notebook, and that will be collected by your science teacher. Congratulations! You have finished the first activity. Now, let's move on to the next activity. Activity 2 entitled Under the Sea Hunting. Materials needed: activity notebook, ball pen, video clip of tropical coral reef. Observe the video. From the video, identify the living and non-living things in the tropical coral reef ecosystem and draw them in your activity notebook. Answer the guide question. Describe the appearance of a tropical coral reef. Great job! You're done with activity 2. Now, let's proceed to activity 3. Activity 3 entitled Finding Organism. Materials needed: activity notebook, ball pen, picture of organisms. Procedure: observe the given pictures. Choose the organisms living in a mangrove swamp. Write your answers in your activity notebook, and this will be collected by your science teacher. You can pause the video to observe the pictures. Picture A, picture B, picture C, picture D, picture E, picture F, picture G, picture H, picture I, picture J. Answer the guide question. What makes a mangrove swamp? Congratulations! We have finished the activities. Now, take time to process the information you acquired by accomplishing the next task. Write your answers in your activity notebook. A. Do you have forest or coral reef or mangrove swamp in your barangay or locality? What are the living organisms found in this place? B. Cite ways on how to protect the forest, coral reef, and mangrove swamp. C. Identify the set of organisms to what relationship they belong. Write the letter of the correct answer. A. Commensal and host. B. Parasite and host. C. Predator and prey. For number 1, orchid and tree. Number 2, fish and algae. 3, snake and rat. 4, mangrove tree and birds. And 5, deer and tree. How does a relationship become beneficial or harmed? Keep this in mind. Tropical rainforest is composed of different varieties of plants, animals, and non-living things. That's why it has the highest biodiversity among the natural ecosystem. Besides trees, which dominate the forest, there are birds, snakes, insects, and other three living animals. Different species of plants grow from the ground or on tree trunks. Different populations interact with each other and with physical environment in the rainforest. Trees being tall limit the amount of sunlight that penetrates the forest floor. Thus, only plants that require only a little amount of sunlight survive as ground cover in the forest. Decomposers on the forest floor break down the dead bodies of organisms into simpler substances. These become nutrients that are absorbed by plant roots. The network of roots, the leaf litter, and most plants on the forest floor hold moisture and prevent soil erosion. Tropical coral reef formed along shallow protected areas of the sea. Corals are the dominant reef organisms. Their hard skeleton is shelter for small fish and many invertebrates. Algae and sea grasses also grow in the reef. Sunlight easily passes through the clear shallow water, hence photosynthesis by these producers occurs at a high rate. Mangrove swamp, confined to the tidal mudflats at the mouth of rivers, estuaries, and lagoons where water is brackish. The dominant plants are bakawan or Rhizophora apiculata, tangal, Cereops tagal, musain, Brigera gymnorhiza. The swamp is a breeding site for fish and prawn, nursery for many species of mollusks and crustaceans, and feeding ground for migratory birds. The water's low salinity enable the fish to breed as compared to the sea. Mangroves shelter the open coast and by trapping drifting sands, prevent suffocation that result to death of adjacent coral reefs. Interactions among living things, rainforest, coral reef, mangrove swamp. Mutualism is when two organisms of different species work together, benefiting from the relationship. Example of mutualism is the bee and the flower. Flowers provide nectar and pollen, which the worker bees collect, while bees help flowers to reproduce by means of spreading the pollen from flower to flower. Commensalism is a type of relationship where one of the organisms benefits while the other is not harmed. Example of commensalism is the sea cucumber and the imperial shrimp. The imperial shrimp hitches a ride on a large sea cucumber along through areas of potential food without harming it. Parasitism is a relationship that involves one organism living with, on, or inside another organism and harming it. An example of parasitism is a mistletoe growing on a tree. It gets nutrients from the tree, causing harm. Predation is a type of relationship between a predator who does the killing and the prey that is being killed. A snake eating a rat is an example of predation. Do you now understand the relationship among living organisms? Now let's proceed to activity 4. Materials needed: activity notebook, ball pen, picture of different organisms. Procedure: using the given pictures, identify the relationship of each organism and indicate as to harmful or beneficial. Picture A. Picture B. Picture C. Picture D.
Picture E. Answer the guide questions. Number 1. Describe what you have observed in the pictures. Number 2. What do the pictures of organisms show? Number 3. Do the organism harm the other organisms in their relationship? Great job! You finished the activity. For activity 5, you will need activity notebook and ball pen. Procedure: complete the information of the interaction among living organisms in the graphic organizer. In the graphic organizer, we have the interaction among living organisms in rainforest, coral reef, and mangrove swamp. Interactions are commensalism, mutualism, parasitism, and predation. For row number 4, give the description of each interaction, and for row number 5, give examples of organisms. Congratulations! You have finished all the activities. Now it's time to reflect. Complete the following sentence prompt. I have learned that. I wish to ask my teacher about. To strengthen what you have learned in this video, accomplish the additional tasks in your activity notebook, and this will be collected by your science teacher. Number 1. List down 5 living things and non-living things that you can find outside your house. Number 2. Observe some interactions among living things near your area. Identify their relationship and discuss as to harmful or beneficial. Let us assess what you have learned. Identify what is being described or asked in each item. Write the letter of the correct answer in your notebook. Your science teacher will collect your answers. Number 1. Sheena collected some things while she was walking home. Which of the following is a living thing? A. Flowers. B. Sand. C. Stones. D. Twigs. Number 2. What do you call the organisms that possess life processes? A. Live animals. B. Living things. C. Moving objects. D. Non-living things. Number 3. Blank is composed of different varieties of plants, animals, and non-living things. A. Drain forest. B. Rain forest. C. Coral reef. Or D. Mangrove swamp. Number 4. Which of the following is confined to the tidal mudflats at the mouth of bodies of water where the water is brackish? A. Drain forest. B. Rain forest. C. Coral reef. D. Mangrove swamp. Number 5. Blank is formed along shallow protected areas of the sea. A. Drain forest. B. Rain forest. C. Coral reef. D. Mangrove swamp. Number 6. Blank is a give and take relationship. A. Commensalism. B. Mutualism. C. Parasitism. D. Predation. Number 7. Bakawan is one of the dominant plants in mangrove swamp. What is the scientific name of bakawan? A. Cereops tagal. B. Brigera tagal. C. Rhizophora apiculata. D. Brigera generalizata. Number 8. What is the relationship between clownfish and sea anemone? A. Commensalism. B. mutualism, C, parasitism, D, predation. Number 9. Why is it that swamp is a good breeding site for fish and prawn? A, because of migratory birds. B, because of water's low salinity. C, because suffocation is prevented. D, because mangroves shelter the open coast. Number 10. One organism benefits while the other is not harmed is called blank. A, commensalism. B, mutualism. C, parasitism. D, predation. That's it! We're done, kids! I hope you have enjoyed and learned a lot from today's session. Have a great day!